bright, talented, and creative. They make masterpieces with their hands and minds. Who are they? What are they working on? You will find it out in today's episode of Art of Making. Making a handmade soap is becoming a popular activity, interesting, exciting, and of course, very creative. In our country, the market for handmade natural soap is not very saturated. Natalia Khorokhodina, having opened her home soap factory, offers consumers exclusive soap with useful properties. Where does soap production begin? Soap making starts from scratch and with the base. Today we're going to tell you in details what soap making from scratch means. We take a certain amount of water, we calculate its amount, and a certain amount of alkali. All this is combined and brought to a certain temperature. We also take different oils, such as coconut, shea butter, cocoa butter, olive, safflower oil, and we melt them. In the end, the oil and alkali are mixed. Soap making from scratch is a process that requires not only skills and experience, but also elementary knowledge of chemical processes. Here you have to deal with alkali, vegetable fats, which in the process of cooking are washed and transformed into soap. This process is actually not hard, but quite dangerous. What is the danger here? The danger is in working with alkali when we make soap from scratch, and here you need to be extremely careful, since alkali can get on the skin, burn it, and etc. And you can't inhale vapors when alkali is mixed with water. Once the alkali has cooled, you can work with it, and you have to be careful. It's an interesting, fascinating process, the result of which is natural soap. In this bucket, there is already melted oil. It's brought to a certain temperature. I'm going to combine it with shea butter and cocoa. We also take an alkaline solution. It's also brought to a certain temperature. Once the oil is connected to the alkaline base, everything is mixed well. In the next step, the alkaline solution is combined with natural dyes and other ingredients. We pour a little bit of this solution into another bowl. Now we are going to combine it with red clay and natural iron oxide. Now I'm going to add essential oil to this composition. We do not add fragrances, but in order for the soap to be suitable for the skincare, we will add essential verbena oil. Essential oils saturate the soap with useful properties and have a softening and moisturizing effect on the skin. And to give the soap a bright color, food dyes are used. The clay mix dye is combined with the remaining alkaline solution without mixing for the pattern of the future soap to remain blurred. After all these manipulations, the finished solution is poured into a silicone mold. Here is our large silicone mold. We made it together with my husband and realized that this is the coolest option for us. It's convenient, and it's easy to get soap from here. And now we do this magic. Pour soap into a spatula with a slow stream, and this will form a pattern. And there will be beautiful stains when we cut. Using various design solutions, soaps are filled with flowers, coffee beans, dried fruits, and herbs to give them an unusual look. We try to decorate soap with what we grow ourselves. This is a local rose. We dry it in a dehydrator, so such a beautiful color remains. When we collect some gift sets, we pack them up, wrap them up with a rope, and insert such a rose. Calendula petals are themselves rich in vitamins, and they can be added to soap. You can make decoration or tincture. You can infuse oils on calendula. The extra effect of soap is that it's better to care for the skin because it contains more vitamins. Cornflower looks beautiful on the top, so we just sprinkle soap with it. And since we dry them in dehydrator, flowers do not lose their blue color. Now that we have soap, it can be decorated. Today we're going to decorate our verbena with gomphrena flowers. We grow it, collect it, and dry it ourselves. This is the type of verbena that we have. It's a hit of sales due to a pleasant smell. It resembles a candy. After we have decorated the soap, it will stand for 24 hours and it can be cut and sent for further maturation for 2-4 weeks. After daily drying, the frozen piece is removed from the mold and sent for trimming. The shape produces 40 pieces of perfumed soap for an average of 150-160 grams. To neutralize alkali, the soap after cutting must be ripened within a month. The variety of recipes allows you to create cosmetic masterpieces. Some products, due to special ingredients, carefully clean and treat the skin. We have about 24 soap varieties, and each is unique in its own way. This is orange and chocolate. It has paprika in composition, turmeric, natural cocoa, essential oil of bitter orange. We also dry these oranges ourselves. And basically, such a big piece, I call it a rather big piece, is enough for 1 month or 1.5 months of daily use. This is lavender. We order essential oil in the Crimea, and we grow these flowers ourselves, or our friends help us with it. We also have products for children. They're based on goat's milk. Instead of water, we use fresh, natural goat's milk. There is a laundry soap. It's rather universal. It can be used for washing the floors, the dishes, or clothes. You can grate it and add to the washing machine as a powder. It's a strong piece, about 200 grams. It will be enough for 3-4 months. In a small workshop, pretty soap products are born. They not only delight the eyes, but also bring in themselves the whole world of purity and aesthetic pleasure. Gulnara Saitova creates warmth and comfort. She knits clothes that not only keep you warm and cold, but also help to emphasize individuality, create your own unique style. When she was a child, her mother taught her how to knit, and that's where it all started. At first, it was clothes for dolls, and then for herself. My favorite hobby has already turned into something more, says Gulnara. Well, she just gave me the simplest skills, and then I just started to get interested in knitting. I myself had already begun to find out some schemes, watch some knitting magazines. That's how knitting came into my life. For almost 50 years, I've been knitting, and I have made a lot of things. So you could actually make an exhibition of the things if they were preserved, which I needed in my life. Gulnara likes to knit with a cup of coffee sitting on a soft chair wrapped in a warm plaid. She's also inspired by the romance of city parks. She bikes to the park, takes a thermos with tea, some sandwiches, and comfortably sits on the lawn and starts to create. New cozy things are slowly born under the soft swish of the spokes, as well as the story of knitting bags.
вязание сумок пришло как-то само по себе. Оно пришло во время карантина.
Idea of knitting bags came on its own. It came during the quarantine. During the quarantine, the factories were closed, and I used to work in a sewing shop, so somehow there was no work. We were sitting at home. And I thought, what if I need a bag? And I watched a lot of different information on the internet, on YouTube, and my daughter advised me to open Instagram and post my bags there. And I gradually watched different masterclasses. There are very interesting shapes of bags. For example, this is from Anna Sakhno. It's called Oreo. To make them, you need to use a special kneading technique. Without watching a masterclass, it's hard to figure out how to make it. So these masterclasses helped me.
Ну и, конечно, собственная фантазия, когда вот что-то делаешь, и вот приходят какие-то мысли, и ну хочется что-то.
And of course, your own ideas when you do something, and you have thoughts and you want to do something of your own. So this dark blue bag here, wooden handles, were also used. So I had this idea that I had this unusual shape, such a voluminous, large and lined bag.
Такая объемная большая сумка на подкладе. А вот эти сумки вот коричневые.
These brown bags are made of natural jute fiber. Jute is a plant which is like flax. You can also make a thread from it. And it's quite strong thread. Jute is usually used somewhere in construction, in technology, and it's sold by such beans in the construction market.
Где-то в строительстве, в технике, и он продается такими бобинами на строительном рынке.
Gulnara never copies work of other knitters, preferring to come up with her own style. Each master has his own style, she believes, so there will always be admirers of your talent.
Такой фасон, как оказалось, понравился многим. Первую сумку я продала вот самой первой. Она была немножко другая, без длинного ремешка, а здесь уже с длинным ремнем.
As it turned out, many liked such a style. The first bag I sold was without a long belt, and here with a long one. But this is the second bag made of jute. I came up with the idea and made it according to it. There is a bottom of plywood. And for this bag, I also used the same technique, as if the rope were braided and the shape was achieved in such an unusual way. These jute bags can handle a heavy weight, and it's quite practical.
Как выносят много килограмм тяжести, достаточно практичные.
All my bags are lined. Here is, for example, flax. This is also natural. It's called kneaded yarn, cotton biscuit. Here natural fabrics are used. A fastener on a magnetic button.
Это называется трикотажная пряжа, хлопчатобумажная, бисквит.
It can be said that all my knowledge to have been embodied in these bags.
Застежки на магнитную кнопку, вот и.
This is my last work. I am knitting this bag now. I also came up with a shape. It's kind of the shape of the jug, or some kind of, well, rather a jug. It will be a jug with a lid, but it will be a bag. The lid will be fastened probably somehow, so that there is a complete option. Maybe it will be lined. I'm not sure yet. Probably I will come up with an idea later.
Вот. Пока я точно не знаю, но, наверное, это как-то родится дальше, как-то в голове рождаются какие-то мысли. Вот. Поэтому вот так.
Gulnara always dreams during knitting, and when the work is already finished, she feels like a real wizard. It happens that it turns out not at all what was intended. You have to dissolve everything and start over. The most difficult thing is then to force yourself to finish what you started. It's very rare, but there are such things that do not exist, such exclusive things that a person invented himself, and now there is no such bag anymore. For example, like this one, or this one. This was made in a single copy, so on the one hand, it brings me joy. Well, how to say the joy of creativity when you do it with your own hands and see the results of your work, and now you see the approval of people. Recent studies have shown that the positive effects of knitting on a person's memory and psychological state are not the only advantages of popular handicrafts. It turns out to be a great way to deal with stress, depression, and high blood pressure. Knitting is great as an emotional detente after a hard day. So get the spokes and start knitting. You'll feel much better. Дамира Абикенова has a degree of an artist designer. For many years, she worked in the sphere of advertising, implemented quite successful business projects, but she always wanted to do something of her own. She wanted freedom and creativity.
Почему-то именно ювелирное искусство меня больше интересовало, хотя я никогда не занималась металлом, не работала. Но, тем не менее, в какой-то степени меня даже пугала эта мысль, потому что реально...
And for some reason it was jewelry that I was interested in, although I never did it. I didn't work with metal. To some extent, I was even scared by the idea of this. My mind suggested that jewelry is difficult, you can't make it. But my heart said that I needed to do this, because what I want to do is a jewelry, create jewelry. Especially since I'm a woman and I like to wear it. And the lack of things that I would like to wear in jewelry shops inspired me even more to create jewelry. Actually, it was such an obsession. It didn't let me go for 5 years. I resisted it for a long time, but then I realized that it was not just a dream of some kind. It could not hold me for so many years. And I decided that after all, I probably need to try. I need to do it.
Решила, что все-таки, наверное, надо попробовать, надо заняться. Я нашла в городе Омске ювелира старого.
I found in the city of Omsk the jeweler Александр Печелатов, who gave me the first basics, the first jewelry lessons. And then it turned out that my hands, my education, everything was somehow adapted to this work. I felt it and very quickly began to master jewelry. It turned out that I could do this. I was even surprised with myself. For 4 years I've been doing jewelry, and I really like it. I feel like it's what I was meant to be doing.
Делаю украшения, и мне очень нравится. Я чувствую, что это мое.
For Дамира, jewelry represents an alternative reality where beautiful stories are told, and there can be no others there. If you leave this idealized mood, then who is this lucky lady for whom Дамира creates jewelry?
У нее определенный свой стиль, вкус, характер.
She has a certain style, taste, character, she's successful, she knows what she wants, she lives a full and vibrant life, she loves and creates. And in all this, my jewelry is supposed to help her.
Во всем должны помочь мои украшения. Хочу сказать, что я, наверное, еще в каком-то поиске своего собственного стиля, но в то же время я люблю и минимализм.
I am still in some kind of search for my own style, but at the same time I love both minimalism and classics. I love the modern interpretation of traditional ornaments, kazu jewelry. I somehow mix it all, and in this way, I create this different jewelry.
И таким образом создаются такие разнонаправленные немножко украшения. Я руководствуюсь тем, что эти украшения носят уже современные женщины. Хотя меня, конечно, вдохновляет наше декоративно-прикладное искусство.
I'm guided by the fact that this jewelry are worn by modern women. Although I'm inspired by our decorative and applied art, I'm inspired by the materials surrounding us, whether it's wood, metal, or stone.
Ну, и в то же время
But at the same time, I would like this jewelry to be worn by a modern woman. Moreover, the jewelry, in my opinion, serves as talisman, and it protects a woman, identifies her character and taste. Therefore, I'm inspired by the images of people and images of animals and natural phenomena. They're partially reflected in my works. And of course, I don't forget about Kazo jewelry, the legacy of Zergers. For many centuries, jewelry has been considered a male profession, but gradually, the men's company was diluted by women jewelers. Having mastered the burner and rollers, they create fierce competition for men. Designer jewelry for our heroine is known and worn not only by local women of fashion, but also by the girls from other countries.
Все мои работы выполнены вручную, исключительно вручную. Я не использую литье, не использую штамповочное оборудование.
All my work is done by hands, only by hands. I don't use casting, I don't use stamping equipment. The whole process from melting to sewing parts is all by hand, using simple hand jewelry tools. I mainly use silver. This metal is somehow difficult to work with. This is noted by many other jewelers. Unlike working with gold, silver is a little capricious, gentler, so you have to work with it more carefully. Creating jewelry is my passion, what I love most in the world, and if I think the stone is beautiful, I will be glad to work with it, Demira says. For me, it's very important that the stones are not synthetic, namely of natural origin, because nature never creates something twice. And each stone is unique in its own way. It's distinguished by its amazing color, pattern, and shape. Therefore, in my products, natural stone is often used as a basic element. But the significance of the stones which are used now seems to me are used more for marketing purposes. I do not attach such importance. I believe that the stones are somehow capable of interacting with a person. But this is not associated with any horoscope and etc. I believe that if you like the stone, then it's already in touch with you. It's yours.
Я считаю, что если камень тебе понравился, то этот камень, он у него уже как бы налаживается с тобой связь. Он твой.
The jeweler advises not to be afraid to stand out from the crowd and take care of nature. Size and shape are key elements, and responsible fashion is the main theme of the season. But still, there are jewels that are beyond the time and fashion. They do not lose their relevance from year to year, from season to season, says Demira.
Мне кажется, из моды никогда не выходит настоящее. Потому что если следовать моде, это...
It seems to me that natural things will always be in fashion. Because if you follow fashion, you follow common trends, common principles, common views. And a person is still an individuality, and therefore the naturalness and authenticity are always valuable. Therefore, I always try to be sincere in my jewelry and make sure that my work carries some of my energy, some kind of positive energy.
Но в то же время такую добрую, положительную.